Before we come to this chart, a few things about the Marfa formed with the help of Alif Lam in the beginning of a Nakira noun. A definite noun was of 7 types, and if you remember, the second of them was that you add Alif Lam to an indefinite noun, it becomes a definite noun. So, about this use of Alif Lam in the beginning of an indefinite noun, please note a few things. Number one, a noun with Alif Lam in the beginning, in the start, will never have tanween at the end. What is tanween? You know it well. Tanween is double fatha, double kasra, or double dhamma. This is called tanween, any one of them. Or you can say each one of them is called tanween. So whenever there is a common noun having a tanween is added with an alif lam in the beginning to make it marfa or definite, what will happen? It will have to delete one of the harakat out of the two, right? For example, you add alif lam to this indefinite noun, that is kitabun. Now when you open the bracket and you make a single word, this will become al-kitabu. So instead of double dhamma, now it has a single dhamma. Similarly, you have qalamun, a pen. You want to make it definite by the addition of an alif lam. So when you add that, now it can never be al qalamun, it will be al qalamu. So tanween and alif lam cannot exist together. Alif lam and tanween cannot exist together. If alif lam is there, there can be no tanween. If tanween is to be there, there can be no alif lam. So they are never combined. Then about the pronunciation of the noun to which an alif lam is added in the beginning, sometimes this lam is pronounced and sometimes it's not pronounced. When this lam is pronounced, actually this is because of the initial letter of the nakira or the indefinite noun to which alif lam has been added. There are letters out of those 28 letters which allow the pronunciation of lam. The others do not allow the lam to be pronounced. Instead, they exhibit or they show their pronunciation twice. That means the first letter after the alif lam gets tashdeed and it is pronounced twice. For example, you know, shams means sun and qamar means moon. So they are of the same category, but their pronunciation is different. Shamsun is sun, S-U-N, sun, and Qamarun a moon. Now when alif lam is added to both of them, this becomes Ash-shamsu, and this becomes al-qamaru. So here lam is being pronounced, and here lam is just written there, but it is silent, not being pronounced. Instead, sheen has got tashdeed, so it will be pronounced double ash-shamsu. Similarly, in Surat al-Fatiha, sirat means path. Siratun a path. This is indefinite noun. Then addition of alif lam was made as siratu. You know, as, this is one pronunciation of saad. Then as siratu. So saad has been pronounced two times. So as siratu. See, here there was double dhamma, here there was double dhamma, here it is single dhamma, and also here it is single dhamma. Here it was double dhamma, and here it is single dhamma when there is alif lam in the beginning. So it should just become your reflex action, being the students of Arabic from now onwards, that whenever there is alif lam in the beginning, you have never to pronounce a tanween at the end of that noun. Why I don't say end of that word? I say at the end of that noun, because both of these are the characteristics of noun. There is no tanween on a verb. There can never be a tanween on the verb. Tanween is also a sign of noun, and alif lam is also a sign of noun. So onwards in Arabic, while reading Quran, whenever you find alif lam in the beginning, you have never, never think of the harf or fail about that word. It has to be a noun. Similarly, whenever there is tanween at the end of a word, it has to be a noun and nothing else. So those huruf are those alphabetical letters which do not allow lam to be pronounced, they are called shamsi huruf. And those which allow the lam to be pronounced, they are called qamari huruf. Al-huruf al-shamsiyya and al-huruf al-qamariyya. Just from this example, the name has been given to them. So, al-huruf al-qamariyya and al-huruf al-shamsiyya. Al-huruf al-shamsiyya. Al-huruf al-qamariyya. Are the shamsi huruf and qamari huruf. We being the Muslims, actually this is the principle of tajweed. We being the Muslims who can recite Quran and who very occasionally and very regularly recite the Holy Quran, they will never make a mistake in this. For example, so al-huruf al-qamariya and al-huruf al-shamsiya. So alif is in al-huruf al-qamariya, ba.
Rabba hadal bayt.
Hazal bayt. So lam has been pronounced, so ba is also here. Rabba hazal bayt. So al-baytu, baytun was nakira, and al-baytu is marfa, a definite noun, but the lam has been pronounced. So from the Quran, sister has given the example. So we come to know that ba is a qamari harf. Ta. At-ta-ibuna. So tell me. Shamsi. So ta will be here. Tha. So here are Shamsi. MashaAllah. An-najmu-thaqibu. So this is something which you already know. I'm just bringing it to your conscious from the unconscious. Yeah, then. Jim, example, Al-Jabbaru, mashallah. So this is common. Ha, Al-Hukamahu, Al-Haqqatu, Kha, Al-Khaliqu.
Al-Khaliq.
So Kha is also Qamari. Dal, Ad-Du'au, Mukhul Ibadah. So Dal is here. Lal, Ad-Dikr. Excellent. Ra. Alif Lam is not there. Ar-Rasikh, Ar-Rabbu. So Ra is also here. Za. الزهادت في الدنيا ليست بتحريم الحلال ولا بعظات المال. تو الزهادت زود زا شمسي. الزيادت then سين. He's right there, Abdul Sami. Sheen Shamsi itself. So sheen is definitely shamsi. Then thad, as samadu. So thad, wadduha. So shamsi. It's not walduha, but wadduha. Then ta. At-Tariq, so Shamsi. Zwa. Zahir. Az-Zahiru. Huwa al-Awwalu wal-Akhiru wal-Zahiru wal-Batinu. So Zwa is also is this category. Ayn. Rabbil Alameen. MashaAllah. So Ayn, Lam has been pronounced. So it's here. Ghain. Alimul Ghaibi wa Shahadati. So Lam has been pronounced, so Ghain is also Qamarin. Fa.
Fitnatun Nar. Al Fitnatun Nar, it's pronounced.
Yes, it's pronounced Al Fitnatu. Qaf. Al Qamar. Kaf. Al Kitabu. Lam.
Allah.
Allah. Al-Laylu. So by writing actually the second Lam is given Tashdeed. So you can treat it either way. Then Meem. Al-Malaikatu. Noon. An-Naru. Wow. Iza waqa'atil waqiyatu. Al waqiyatu. Wow has been pronounced. Ha. That is a verb. Al haqum uttakasu. That is other ha. Al huda. That is the example. Hakim is ha, not ha.
No, Al Harun.
Harun is already a proper noun. So you cannot add Alif Lam to this. Al huda is the best example. After all, he is an imam. Atar. You have to prove your name. So ha, Hamza, Hamza is there. Then ya, al yaqutu wal marjanu. So al yaqutu, Lam has been pronounced. What was the example here? Iyaka. So al yam is the word, but that starts from Hamza. Al yom is all right. So this is about al huruf al shamsiya. First look at the words used throughout in the chart. Two words have been used in different forms. Kitab and Hakim. Kitab means book and Hakim means wise. So different forms of Kitab throughout. Kitab, Kitab, Kutub, now is plural, but broken plural. This is Kitaba, some other form. Then Kitabai, some other form. Kutub, some other form. Kitabu, Kitabu, same form. Then Al-Hakimi, Hakimin. This is a proper noun, this is a nakira. So this is a definite noun, this is an indefinite noun. Then this is Musanna form. Then this is a feminine form. Then this is having kasra in the end, but single kasra, here there was double. Then here it is feminine form, then this is a plural form, but plural of the masculine, but a broken plural at the same time. Then this is a musanna form. So the alternation of the same two words you find throughout in this, and the same is here. This is also kitab, this is also kitab, this is also some form of kitab which you have to recognize. This is also some form of kitab, this is also some form of kitab. No changes. Some form will be singular, the other will be musanna, the other will be plural. Then you will find the change regarding the i'rab. Then you will find the change regarding the gender. Right? Sometimes you will find the change about alif lam having added or deleted. So same is the case here. No alif lam, there is an alif lam. There is an alif lam, but the form is changing in some other way. So here we have to actually know the mechanics of the language. You know, in English, book of the wise man, book of a wise man. You know, these are two words, one word and the other word. This means kitab, book, and this means wise. Now in English translation, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There is no, at the most you can say there is a representation of the alif lam. But here there is no representation of parallel word, a parallel letter for A. So from where the Arabs get the meanings of A, from where they get the meanings of of, from where they get the meanings of is, the same two words, al-kitabu hakeemun. Now this is, the book is wise. Al-kitabani hakeemani, the two books are wise. So from where this are has come, from where this is has come, this is actually the objective of this chart. How we will understand the subject, that we will keep in mind our translation before us. And first we will try to find out what is the common thing in this translation. Then we will find out what is common in this translation. Then we will see what is common in this translation. Then in each column, we will try to find out the common things in the Arabic text. And then from that we will get the clue that to get this meaning, what Arabs do. All the things are a book and hakim. But what is special in this column? Why they have been separated into three? What separates them? Yes, the first column has got of in all the expressions. Of, and of. Of course, there is no preposition. There is no verb. What is? Yes, all have got the helping verb, is, are, is. So these are the helping verbs. Now, to have this meaning of all, these are the constructions. Now, covering these two columns for a while, we'll concentrate upon this. And what will be our method of concentration? That we will just analyze each one of them about the things which we studied in the last 3-4 lectures. That is regarding the four basic things about the noun, because we know in the case of this relationship, in the sixth number of the definite noun, we found that if a noun is related to a definite noun, that also becomes a definite noun. So because this is the relationship type of noun or construction, so this noun is indirectly definite or indefinite. So we will not find out here individually that whether this noun is definite or not. So we will not note this, whether it is definite or not. We will note instead two things other than that. And one is whether it has got alif lam in the beginning or not, and whether its i'rab is light or heavy. We cannot erase all the three columns I've just erased one column, but you take full page of your notebook and then on one page make complete chart of what I am doing here. I will erase, but you will move to the next part of the page. Don't erase it. So kitab is a word, basically a noun. We will treat it in different possibilities. Make a chart of kitab, you can say. Number one, in every case, what we have to consider is i'rab. The most important thing in this language is the i'rab. So first of all, we treat kitab in regarding number. So regarding number, first singular, kitabun. This is rafa form, this is nasab form, and this is jar form. So this was indefinite, nakira. Now we make it marfa, al kitabu. Now it will be without tanween. So al kitabu. You also do the next one. Nasab form, marfa of kitaban. You have not been asked. Why al-kitaban? What you have to do to make it a marfa from this? This is indefinite, you have to make it definite. What you have to do?
Al.
Al. And what change?
No tanween.
So, al-kitaba. Excellent. Everybody should be attentive. Anybody does not understand why that change has been made, he or she should immediately stop me. Otherwise, you will waste your time. It's very important. Those who are viewing Al-Kitaba. So, this was indefinite, singular, indefinite in nasab form. This is singular, definite in nasab form. Then next, Al-Kitabi.
الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله.